Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to create .exe executable files from Python apps. So in my previous videos, I have showed you how to create this type of very simple calculator. So it has features of both light theme and a dark theme. So you can toggle it from this button and you can add, you know, or multiply these numbers, you can clear it, you can divide, so you can do all these things. You can also convert it to light theme and you can, you know, do all these different things on this calculator. So this is a very simple calculator and it's a GUI file and we are running it from PyCharm. As you can see, we are just running it from PyCharm. So in this video, what I am going to show you is how to create an executable version of this entire project. So do watch the video till the end. I can guarantee if you watch the video till the end, you'll be learning a lot of new things. And if these videos are really helping you, please do mention that on our comment sessions. I always read all of your comments. That really encourages me to make more the similar kind of videos. So let's set a target of 100 comments under this video. So now to create executable of this project, what you will need is you need to first go to terminal and you will need to install a Python package called PyInstaller. So you can go to your browser and just open a new tab and type PyInstaller, and you can always read the official documentation from their official website. So this is what we are going to use. So this link also I'm going to provide right in our channel description, and here we have this couple of comments. So let's install PyInstaller. So this project I have created on PyCharm and our package manager is UV. So I'm going to use UV here as well. So if you are very new to UV, you can always watch this video. That's going to help you to learn this latest Python package manager tool called UV, and I am sure you're going to love it. So let's install PyInstaller. So UV pip install PyInstaller and just simply hit enter. So that's going to immediately start installing our PyInstaller. You can see how quickly it is installing. So only, you know, time it's going to take is to download this package. Apart from that, it's just lightning speed. So you can see how quickly it is installed, right? All these different packages. So yeah. So once our PyInstaller get installed, you can now execute your next command, that is PyInstaller, then your file name. So basically our project or the file name is calculatorgs.py. So that is what we are going to execute. So PyInstaller space dash dash one file, because we want to create a single file and it is a single window, right? So window, and then we are going to provide the file name, that is calculatorgs.py. And if you want to learn more about why you use all these different flags, you can always refer to this article. So this official documentation will help you to learn more about these different flags. Alright, so now just simply write this much and just simply hit enter, and that's going to immediately start initializing, you know, some of the different modules and component, and then it's going to create a distributable file. And there you go. So you can see our build folder gets created along with dist folder as well. So if we expand this dist folder, you will get a exe. So this is what we are going to run. So just simply browse to this folder. So open in Explorer, and here is our calculatorgs.exe. So you can just simply double click on this exe, and you can see that our calculator exe is rightly open. So you can do all these different things that you can do from code as well. So this is basically a proper executable file. So you can, you know, take this to different laptops, you can also share it with your friends and show that you have just created a calculator app, and EXE, you can bundle it and can take it to other systems as well. Now this is a very easy project. We don't have any other files, everything that are there within the same file, but there could be projects which is, you know, a little big enough. So for example, I have created one more project called this rock paper scissor game. So let's open that, and here you can see we have all these different files. So that includes this mp3 file, gif, you know, again mp3 file, another gif, and our main project file as well. So if I run this, you can see it's going to look something like this. So it has, yes, I mean, so it has all sound in the background.
It's a tie.
So how to, you know, create EXE file of this type of complicated project is what I'm going to show you in the next video. It's a little tricky, but I am sure if you follow that video, you'll be able to learn the entire thing right over there as well. So my following video will be continuation to this video only. All right. And also, if you're interested to learn how to create this type of projects, then I am, you know, every week I am posting new videos on this playlist. So I'm sure if you watch this playlist, you'll be able to learn a lot of new things. And entire source code and everything I'm also sharing on our Geeky Script official website along with our GitHub account as well. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.